Yeah, and I think, you know, one of them is earmarking an exhibition I want to do on civil servants.
I'm sort of scab through this, trying to find something. And then once again, it's that sort of thing where I've got a picture and I've got an article and they come together and it's just leave it up to divine intervention. I actually don't know what it says, but most of the time it's so apt. I don't know how it happens, but it's great. There's different tension between them. There was like something else underneath it. This background is from the previous foreground, and that foreground was painted away. I only kept the background. On metal, and a lot of it is sort of taking the surface away.
It's all necessary.
This is a rust converter, and I will now take the highlights and seal them so they don't rust as rapidly as the rest. And like if you go like this, it changes. You know, you get the reflection. Like if you stand here, I don't know if you can see it there, but how it changes as I started grinding, all this beautiful color came out. So it's a bit of an excavation process as well. I just love all the scarring and the story that the surface tells before. Oh, I call that paper flower because that's another name for bougainvillea, is paper flower. I love them. Sometimes I live with a canvas and then just one day, like an epiphany, I know exactly what must, there's no doubt in my mind what must go on there. So it's like these images are floating around and they find their partners, and it's like science. It is equal that. There's no doubt. It's not like, shouldn't I? It's like I wake up in the morning like, that's what must go on that surface that's been standing around for a year. So, you know, this is up here waiting for that moment.